here in Plano, Texas. You might be wondering what I'm doing in Plano, Texas. And actually, I started off by coming from Dhaka to Hong Kong, Hong Kong to Toronto, Toronto, then eventually I got here to Plano to meet none other than John and Hank Green.
I'm way overexposed.
Yeah.
Wow. I'm here with John.
Yeah.
Whoa. And you're very, very tall.
Yeah, I know, and very white in this picture.
So Hank, where are we and what are we doing?
We're in Plano, Texas, and we're hanging out with probably what will end up being hundreds of nerdfighters.
Because I need Harry Potter, like a Grindy Low needs water, and as that day approaches, my need grows. Osseo, deathly hallows, incendio, book sales embargoes, it'll be like Phoenix tears on a broken nose. Osseo, deathly hallows.
Here in Plano, Texas today.
Right. Yeah, that's a real hard act to follow. Hank, thanks for you. And then I have to speak, yeah.
You know that Hank thinks that John is like one of the most important writers along with J.K. Rowling. I actually think Hank is selling John a bit short because I think John Green will go down in history as changing the way writers interact with people. Like, when I was in high school, and I really feel real old by saying that, but when I was in high school, I mean, I'm Hank's age, but like, I guess I'd hack me, but like, when I was in high school, I would have to read these books, and I'd have to kind of guess what the author meant when he was saying something. And sometimes it would be hard. If it was Shakespeare, they were dead. If they were like J.D. Salinger, they're like a recluse. But like, here you have Hank, And John, you know, he's led us into his life. And so when I'm reading Paper Towns, it's not that I'm reading a book. I feel like I'm being told the story by a friend. And I get all the in-jokes, I get all the, you know, his personality he's going through, and really, it really feels like a personal connection. And I mention this because that's kind of the same spirit I did when I went to Bangladesh. Really, at the end, I'm kind of hoping that when you see my videos online, it's like you have a personal connection with me and my journey. So thank you so much.
We're going to be raising money for Save the Children, USA. They're going to be, and everything that we're going to do is they're going to be voted on that Challenge Poverty video.
Right.
And what's going to happen in Westport?
Every stop from now until Westport on the Great American Tour de Nerdfighting, we'll be raising money for Save the Children. Then when we go to Westport, we will give the money to Save the Children, and we will continue this conversation about how to address poverty, particularly in Bangladesh.
And you'll be able to see where it goes because I'll be going back to Bangladesh, and you get to see what happens based on your vote.
So, thanks to Sean for being awesome, and thanks to you for being awesome.
Thanks.
Thanks, man.